It's no secret that the $699 M1 Mac Mini is a killer option for those wanting a powerful computer but don't want to break the bank. Traditionally, however, PCs have always held this spot. So what if we built a $699 PC and put it up against a $699 M1 Mac Mini? Well, that's a good question, so let's just do it. A few caveats: the only constraint for this build is that it needs to be around $699. This means we don't need to exactly match the RAM and SSD capacity. Another thing to keep in mind is that I'm located in Australia, so PC parts are often 10 to 15% more expensive than in the US, for example. Also, we're in the middle of a parts shortage due to a certain pesky virus, particularly with graphics cards. This means we've got a very limited amount of parts to choose from, and the parts that are available often have a markup due to scarcity. Because of this, the total cost for this build ended up exceeding the budget. However, if you are located in the US or UK, for example, and the pandemic was not a factor, this build would pretty much be bang on $699, even more so if you were willing to pick up one or two parts secondhand. Like the M1 Mac Mini, this build is not purpose-built for a specific task like gaming or editing. The goal was to produce a build that would fare well in a variety of different tasks. A good all-rounder, you could say. A 6-core 3600X Ryzen CPU paired with a B550 motherboard is a good base that can be overclocked down the road if necessary. 16GB of 3600MHz DDR4 RAM will be enough for most tasks, and even some light 4K editing. A GTX 1650 will also come in handy for video editing, and some light to moderate gaming, despite the large price markup due to the parts shortage crisis. Anyway, that's enough about the parts. Let's get started on the build. Stay tuned for a follow-up video where we benchmark the M1 Mac Mini against our $699 M1 Mac Mini killer PC.